Farmer bodies and opposition parties have called a Bharat Bandh today to protest against the new farm bills passed by Parliament this week. On Thursday, farmers from Punjab and Haryana, which are key producers of wheat and rice, blocked railway tracks, forcing the cancellation of some trains on local routes. Several farmer bodies have come together under the banner of All India Kisan Sangharsh Committee for Friday's Bharat Bandh, which is expected to disrupt road and rail traffic in several states. Intense protests are expected in Punjab, Haryana, Western Uttar Pradesh, Telangana and some parts of Maharashtra. The Election Commission of India will announce the dates for Bihar Assembly elections due in November. It'll be the first assembly poll to be held amid the coronavirus pandemic. The RJD and other opposition parties had called for postponing the polls due to the pandemic. The poll panel had chalked out detailed guidelines for the elections to ensure safety and social distancing amid the raging COVID crisis. India has warned China against any unilateral changes on the line of actual control and insisted that the issues can only be resolved with talks. The Foreign Ministry's warning came after the sixth round of talks between military commanders of both sides. Underscoring India's push for restoration of status quo ante, the ministry said disengagement is a complex process. It further added that it requires redeployment of troops by each side towards their regular posts on their respective sides of the line of actual control and reciprocal action. A coronavirus-positive woman delivered four babies at BRT Medical College in Uttar Pradesh's Gorakhpur district, officials said on Thursday. While three babies are healthy, the fourth one is on a ventilator. The 26-year-old woman from the Deoria district reached the Medical College Trauma Center on Tuesday night and tested positive there. As per the doctors, the delivery was premature.
Chief Minister Arvind Kejriwal on Thursday said experts believe that second wave of the coronavirus infection which hit Delhi a while back is on the decline. From July 1st to August 17th, we were in control. We noticed that cases increased and it reached 4,500 new cases on September 17th and is now coming down. So experts believe that the second wave of coronavirus that hit Delhi is now on the peak and its intensity will be less in the coming days, he said addressing the media. Kejriwal said Delhi recorded approximately 4,500 cases earlier this month. After that, the cases started to decline and in the last 24 hours, 3,700 cases have been reported in the national capital. After being summoned by the NCB in the drug probe related to actor Sushant Singh Rajput's death, actress Sara Ali Khan has returned to Mumbai. The actress is due to appear before the NCB for interrogation on Saturday. Deepika Padukone, who was shooting for Shakun Batra's next film in Goa, is also on her way to Mumbai along with husband actor Ranveer Singh. NCB has confirmed that Deepika will join the probe on Saturday, while Rakul Preet Singh and Karishma Prakash will join the investigation on September 25th.
More than 200 national and international scholars, academicians and artists on Thursday released a statement in support of former JNU student Omar Khalid, who is under arrest for his alleged role in the February Delhi riots. The signatories have called the investigation a premeditated witch hunt and said Khalid was falsely implicated by the Delhi police under the Unlawful Activities Prevention Act. They have demanded that the government free Khalid and all those falsely implicated and unjustly incarcerated for protesting against the CAA and NRC. Some prominent people among the 208 signatories include linguist Noam Chomsky, author Salman Rushdie, Amitav Ghosh, Arundhati Roy, Ramchandra Guha and Rajmohan Gandhi, filmmakers Meera Nair and Anand Patwardhan, historians Romila Thapar and Irfan Habib, and activists Medha Patkar and Aruna Roy.
The International Civil Aviation Organization has advised Pakistan to undertake immediate corrective actions and suspend the issuance of any pilot licenses in the wake of a scandal over falsified licenses, Reuters has reported. The recommendations came days after Pakistan opened a criminal probe into 50 pilots and 5 civil aviation officials who allegedly helped them falsify credentials to secure pilot licenses. The pilot scandal has tainted Pakistan International Airlines, which has been barred from flying into Europe and the United States. American cult bike manufacturer Harley-Davidson on Thursday said it's discontinuing sales and manufacturing operations in India. Harley's exit comes a decade after it started selling its premium bikes in the country. The company is looking to tie up with a partner to run its business in the country. The India action will include a workforce reduction of approximately 70 employees, the company said. In a separate statement, Harley-Davidson said it plans to close its manufacturing facility in Haryana and significantly reduce the size of its sales office in Gurgaon.